This video goes with section 15 of Hansen and Quinn's Greek and Intensive course and covers the second declension. You can refer to Hansen and Quinn pages 25 to 27 for their coverage of the material, which they revisit in the appendix pages 622 and 624 and 25. This introduction to the second declension teaches you how to form words that end in -os, mostly masculine but some feminine nouns, or -on, which are neuter nouns. Our examples are logos, logu, ha, word, and ergon, ergu, ta, deed. Just like in the vocabulary lists, glossaries, and dictionaries, what you get when you're introduced to this word is the nominative singular, the genitive singular, and the article, which is how we conventionally show whether a noun is masculine, feminine, or neuter. Most, but not all, of the second declension in -os are masculine, and all of the second declension in -on are neuter. So we see logos with the masculine article -ha, and ergon with the neuter article -ta. We're going to be adding endings to the stem of the words. So to get the stem of any noun in the Greek second declension, go to the genitive, the second word, and take off the -ou. With these two words, you'll get the same result if you took the ending off the nominative, but that won't always be the case. Now we need endings to add to those stems. We'll make a chart for the singular and the plural. Greek has a dual too, but it's rare enough not to teach you. For the nominative, which we use for the subject of a sentence and things that agree with it. The genitive, which will do lots of things, including possession and other things that can be translated with the English of, and it's used as the object of some prepositions. Dative, which will do lots of things, including indirect objects and other things that can be translated by to or for, and it's used as the object of some other prepositions. And accusative, which will do lots of things, and especially direct objects, and also is the object of some prepositions. And vocative, which is only used for direct address when you're calling out to someone or something. We'll also need to be ready for masculine and feminine endings to be different from neuter endings. So here are the endings for the second declension nouns ending in -os, which are masculine and feminine. -Os, -oo, -o, -on, -e, -oi, -own, -ois, -oos, and oi. Now we need the endings for the second declension nouns ending in -on, which are neuter. -On, -oo, -o, -on, -on, -a, -own, -ois, -a, -a. Nouns have persistent accent. The accent wants to stay the same type in the same place that it is on the nominative singular form of the word. Notice that the neuter nominative, accusative, and vocative singular are all the same, and you need context to tell the difference. The plural forms of the neuter nominative, accusative, and vocative are also the same as each other, and again you'll need context. Side note, the neuter nominative, accusative, and vocative plural ending is always a short alpha, even when we meet it in other places besides the second declension. The next thing to notice is that the masculine and feminine forms for genitive and dative singular are the same as the ones for the neuter, so there's not quite as much to memorize as it looks like. And the same goes for the plural. Now, let's put these things together for logos and ergon. Here are our stems, and here are our endings. We take the stem, and we add the endings. Here are the stems of logos all laid out for us. And now let's add the endings. Logos, logu, logo, logon, loge, logoi, logon, logois, logus, logoi. And the accents, trying to stay an acute on that first omicron, which it is able to do on all of the words. So here we have word, of word, for word, word used as a direct object, word when you need to address a word, words, of words, for words, words as a direct object, and words when you need to talk to them. Now let's do the same for ergon. Here are all the stems laid out for us, and now let's add the endings. Ergon, ergu, ergo, ergon, ergon, erga, ergon, ergois, erga, and erga. And let's add the accents, trying to stay an acute on that epsilon, which it can do on all of the forms. So now you see we have ergon, deed, ergu, of deed, ergo, for deed, ergon, deed, ergon in the vocative, deed. In the plural, erga, deeds, ergon, of deeds, ergois, for deeds, erga, deeds, and erga, deeds. Notice again how the genitive, notice how the nominative and accusative and vocatives look the same as each other in the plural and in the singular. Let's try again with some other nouns to practice and to show you more accent variations. We're going to use doron, doru, ta, gift, nesos, nesu, hey, island, adelphos, adelphu, ha, brother, and anthropos, anthropu, ha, human being or man. Here are the endings and our rule. And here are the stems of doron, the genitive without the u, all laid out for us. Let's add the endings. And the accents, this time trying to stay a circumflex on the omega, but it has to change into an acute when the ending is long in the genitives and the datives, according to the rules for accent, which won't let a circumflex stay over the second to last syllable if the last syllable is long. So here we have doron, gift, doru, of gift, doro, for gift, doron, gift, and doron, gift in the singular. Dora, gifts, doron, of gifts, doros, for gifts, dora, gifts, and dora, gifts in the plural. Now, let's do nesos. Here are the stems, and let's add the endings. Even though this is a feminine noun, it has the same endings as logos and adelphos and anthropos, which are all masculine, because it's a second declension noun. And now we're going to try to add the accents, which want to stay a circumflex over that eta at the beginning. But again, in the places where the ending is long, it has to turn into an acute. Now, notice that in the nominative and vocative plural, we don't have any trouble with that circumflex over the eta because omicron iota, oi, at the end of a word is short for the purposes of accent. Let's do adelphos. Here are the stems all laid out, and let's add the endings. This time, the accent is going to want to try to be an acute or grave over that last syllable over the omicron. But I get to tell you again about an exception to the rules for persistent accent. In first and second declension nouns and adjectives with an acute on the ultima, the accent changes to a circumflex in the genitive and dative. For this noun, there's also a special exception in the vocative, and the accent is an acute on the alpha. It goes all the way back, even though in all the other forms, it's on the last syllable. So, Adelpha. The plural is as you expect, with a circumflex on the ultima in the genitive and the dative. So here we have Adelphos, brother, Adelphu, of brother, Adelpho, for brother, Adelphon, brother, Adelpha, brother, Adelphoi, brothers, Adelphon, of brothers, Adelphois, for brothers, Adelphus, brothers, and Adelphoi, brothers. Now, finally, let's do the same with Anthropos. Here's the stem and the endings already done for you. And let's look at the accents. Trying to stay an acute on the alpha, but when the endings are long, the accent has to move to the second to last syllable in the genitive and dative, singular and plural, and in the accusative plural, because with a long last syllable, an acute cannot stay third to last. So it has to move. And so here we have anthropos, man, anthropou, of man, anthropo, for man, anthropon, man, anthropa, man, anthropoi, men, anthropon, of men, anthropois, for men, anthropous, men, and anthropoi, men. And that's what I need to tell you about the second declension, and you should be able to put it into practice in drills, in class, and in translation.